Company now Visakha Industries is in focus as the company has announced its foray into electric vehicle segment. Company said that the new business segment will complement their existing businesses. We have Mr. Krishna, who is the joint MD of Visakha Industries, joining in on the show now. Mr. Krishna, hi, welcome to the show. If you can just start by telling us about this new venture where you're venturing into the electric vehicle segment, and how exactly does it complement your current business?
Yeah, hi. Thanks for having me. I think this has been something of a long due for us, especially when we are into solar in a big way. I think Atom, which is our roof cum solar product, is an interesting space that we are in, as the whole EV is talking about electric charging stations, and everybody is talking about how can we improve the network to facilitate the transition from the existing ICE engines to the electric space. And we feel that if the whole electric revolution is not backed by solar or any clean energy for that matter, the entire exercise will be futile. And that's where we see Atom as a perfect fit. Every charging station needs a good roof, and every charging station will need a good, clean, green power source. And that's where we feel that the synergies can be of great help in terms of energy generation. Atom can generate almost about 40% more than any traditional green power available today in the market. So I think that is where we are looking to add value to this whole ecosystem of charging stations.
All right. So Atom Charge, Atom Life, VNEX Solutions, Vamsi, those are the businesses that you've given out. Give us a sense in terms of numbers. What kind of a business opportunity could it present, and which year will this business opportunity emerge? You'll be investing some money, I'm guessing. So give us a brief number on that. And does this does these new businesses start contributing in FY23, or is it a story of FY22 itself?
Yeah. So great, Nigel. I think over the years, I think everybody's been watching us in terms of the products that we are touching upon. And most of them have this sustainability touch. I think now is the time where we've actually come out with a good plan in terms of how can we take this to people at large? How can we take this sustainability, make it more easy to adapt, make it more affordable to adapt? And I think that's where this whole plan of VNEX Solutions or Atom Life combined with the charging stations comes in. VNEX Solutions is more of a tech platform. It is a very easy to use, B2B and B2C tech platform where I can just order anything related to construction, right from residential, commercial to industrial. I can pretty much order it like Swiggy or any of the new tech solutions available in the construction space. And the whole thing will give you a clean report in terms of how sustainable your construction is. So that's as far as VNEX Solution is concerned. The investment for that will be mainly to develop the technology. We have already actually have the beta version up launched online on Android and Apple as we speak. The investment in that will be more of an OPEX, because that will be project based and service based. So depending on that, anywhere between 10 to 30 crores to start with in the first year is what we are looking at. In terms of Atom Life, I think it's a very interesting space where we are bringing together a bunch of sustainable products. It's not like, I cut trees and I claim to be eco-friendly. We actually have developed an in-house team which is doing R&D in terms of how green the products are, how eco-friendly we are really. Are we really true to what we speak? And that is really where Atom Life comes. We really envision Atom Life to be a place where you can simply walk in and walk out and not bother about, am I having a negative impact? Am I having a carbon negative impact? It's all done for,
Sure, that point is taken, Krishna. Mr. Krishna, that point is taken, but let's get down to some business statistics on this. Have you already started generating business from this particular business segment? For example, even the charging stations, have you reached out to customers? Is there any sort of order book that you're working with, or is this still in nascent stages? Tell us what the plan is in terms of numbers.
Sure. So I was actually just getting to that. In fact, we just launched it. We've done a couple of prototypes for the charging stations. And Atom Life is under construction right now, actually. The first store that we are going to launch is under construction. And the overall spend towards Atom Life will be anywhere about 20 crores to look at this year. And in terms of charging stations, also will be in that same number, because we are planning to combine the two as a solution. And in terms of revenues, I think it will be good, very concrete numbers. I think they should start clicking in from FY23. We will have numbers in from 22, of course, but the full turnover ratio in terms of Atom Life as a division to start with. And just to give you a sight of the numbers, what we are expecting is we plan to open this up to our dealer fraternity, which we have, you know, over 30 years. We have about 10,000 dealers across India. And this is what our strategy is, to reach out to the tier two markets where the business is going to click in the next coming 2 to 3 years, and where we have an Atom Life store everywhere you go. So that's really what we're trying to build here.
Okay, all right. You know, revenue projections, I think you're not being able to give as of now, but you broke up, you know, these three divisions. I think it was 10 to 20 crores, 30 crores, and approximately, you know, 10 to 20 crores again. So I think on all these three new business ventures that you're talking about, you'll be spending around 50 crores. Did we get that number right?
Absolutely.
Yeah. Okay. All right. So we've understood a fair bit about the new business. Tell us about the core business. On the roofing business, I believe, you know, cement prices have been more or less steady or moved up a little bit. Also, the other factor is that fiber. Fiber, I think, comes in from Kazakhstan, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah.
Availability as well has been a bit of an issue. Input costs have gone up. So have you taken a price increase? And can you maintain your margins for this division, that's your building products division, at the same levels that you did in quarter four? Or is it likely to see a bit of a downtick?
So absolutely spot on, Nigel. I think the costs have increased because of the logistic issue that we had. But we are a little positive this year as well, as indicated last time. We look forward to a good growth this year. In fact, we have announced a 50 crore additional investment in this business as well this year. So we should get that plant up and out by Jan 2022. And regarding the prices, we have taken a hike. But as you know, the entire lockdown is very unpredictable. Different states have different rules this time. But nevertheless, we are trying our best to get to our original targets. And we still feel that this year will be good, positive for the roofing business. For sure.
What is the price increase in this quarter so far? Give us a rough number at least.
So maybe about, up to now, what we're seeing is anywhere around 5 to 7 rupees, okay. what we've seen. But then again, I don't want to, you know, stick. I want the market to open up and then see how best we can. Because last year, because of the lockdowns, we had actually a lot of pent-up demand. So we are looking at that in terms of how best we can service this year as well.
Oh, got it. And for the year, for the entity on the whole, you're looking at a double-digit growth, I think, in terms of revenue.
Absolutely. Yeah, we're doing, again, a fourth plant expansion of another 75 crores for the boards as well. Yeah. So on an investment front, we are looking at good growth, definitely. I think FY 22 to 23 will be something of more, you know, good contribution in returns is what we are expecting.
Okay, thanks so much, Vamsi, for stopping by and giving us a brief insight into your new thoughts with regard to your new business. And also, as you're telling us, because of the lockdown, you're still waiting by for those price increases. But otherwise, prices have moved up by around 5 to around 7 rupees. That's with regard to the core roofing business. Slip into a short break, come back. Manisha Gupta will be waiting for us. She'll focus on the commodity and currency space.